What's up, for Trailer Fam? The Las Vegas project continues, and so far, I only have like about a weekish left. I've actually gone to almost every single nightclub. I've gone to everyone except two. So now I'm really focused on the pool parties, and for today, I'm going to Daylight. It's a super beautiful day out. I think now we've hit the point. Every day's gonna be beautiful. Every day the sun's out. Every day is perfect for a great day club.
Esse popozão.
Vegas pool parties slash day clubs, I feel like the ones that are typically mentioned are like Dre's Day Club, Encore Beach Club, Wet Republic, you know, but I feel like, no joke, I think Daylight is the most underrated pool party and day club on the Vegas Strip. I loved Daylight. Now, when you first walk in, it's all basically structured as a square, which I really enjoyed, I think, especially for a pool party and day club. And here's the reason why. With other day clubs and pool parties, you walk in, and the DJ's like in this awkward corner section, and it's kind of spread out and elongated like that. And there's these, you know, kind of side tangents and stuff like that, where depending on where you are, you won't even see the DJ, right? And the action, so to speak, or the intensity of that pool party is almost spread out in these awkward sections. And what I like is that Daylight is just one square, everything focused on the stage, right? Everything kind of focused on the stage. You have the pool in the middle and the tables on basically the ends of it. And I really love that layout because that way you can be in the pool and instantly see the DJ, right? You could be at a table or basically sitting on one of the lounge couches or whatever and see the DJ right there. You could be right on the dance floor in front of the DJ and obviously see it, you know? So I like that no matter where you are in Daylight, it's really easy to see the pool. It's really easy to see the DJ. In addition, Daylight, hands down, have the best stage setup of any pool party I've been to yet in Vegas. I love, also you have the typical screens, you know, and then you have that kind of like half circle thing above it. It actually kind of reminded me of like a WWE or WWF, like Titantron. Like that's actually what it reminded me of, you know, expecting to see a wrestler walk out of it. That's exactly what it looked like. You know, you have like the big screens, you know, obviously all the, you know, different things going on in the visualizer, and then you have this, you know, like I said, half circle with all these pyrotechnics and obviously lights and lasers attached to it. So I thought that stage setup, hands down, the best yet when it comes to Vegas pool parties. Now, moving on to the vibe, because also I'm producing songs about the day clubs, nightclubs, and after hours club. Here in Las Vegas, Daylight was one that was easy to pick up on right away, but also hard. And here's what I mean. I'm still, even at the time of this video, because I was just there earlier today, I'm not sure exactly what the vibe is going to be, or in terms of the exact genre, because typically on these recaps, I like to say, okay, here's the subgenre of EDM that I might produce it in. When it comes to Daylight, all I know is the song is going to be intense. That's all I know. WEDM, so the two vibes I was kind of going back and forth between were either like almost like dubstep, heavy bass, trap, like almost twerk style music, or big room. So I've even been thinking like almost like a jungle, like if you think of like Jack U, like Diplo and Skrillex combined, like a Jack U style track where it has the like upbeatness and the intensity of big room, but with this intense, gritty, hard-hitting feel of dubstep and trap. And obviously, like I said, who knows how it's going to come out when I'm going to produce it, but I think in some way, I really want to combine those two elements, because obviously big room is super intense and energetic, right? It's like 128 BPM typically, the four on the floor kick drum style, and then also blending that with the hard-hitting, almost half-tempo, half-time style of trap and dubstep, especially with those hardcore synths.